flashhumananatomy.com.
In this lesson, I will talk about the muscles of the thoracic wall. In the muscles of the thoracic wall, we count in the pectoralis major, pectoralis minor, the subclavius, and the serratus anterior. We should start by explaining the pectoralis major. The origin of this muscle is here, on the clavicle, the medial half of the clavicle. If you listen to my lessons in my software about bones, you will see that I said that clavicle can be divided into 3/3. The medial one here, the middle one here, and the lateral one here. In previous lessons, I said that the trapezius muscle is attached on the lateral third, and here on the medial third we have the pectoralis major. Now, as I said, it originates here. It also originates from the anterior surface of the sternum. So this is the sternum here. If we look at it from here, you will be able to see that this is the rib and this is the sternum. And right between the rib and the sternum, there is a cartilage, right? So pectoralis major also originates here from the superior 6 cartilages. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, from these superior 5 cartilages. Now, where does it insert? It inserts in the intertubercular groove of the humerus here. So this is the humerus. Now, because it originates from the clavicle here, and it also originates from the sternum and the cartilages, we have two heads of the pectoralis major. The sternocostal head down there and the clavicular head here where it originates from the clavicle. Now, the clavicular head of this muscle is innervated by C5 and C6. The sternocostal head is innervated by 7, C7, C8, and D1. These heads also have the different functions. The clavicular head flexes the humerus. The sternocostal head extends the humerus. And the muscle as a whole abducts and medially rotates the humerus. It medially rotates it because it is attached more lateral, as you can see it here. Now, not only humerus and clavicle are affected by this muscle. If you look at here, the clavicle is the bone that is attached, or actually it articulates with humerus and with clavicle here. So the scapula is also the bone that is affected by the contraction of this muscle. And actually, this muscle draws the scapula anteriorly and inferiorly. Now I should talk about the pectoralis minor. And here is the pectoralis minor. The origin of this muscle is right here on the ribs. And actually the third, fourth, and the fifth rib, right close to their cartilages. The place where it attaches is here, the medial border and the superior surface of the coracoid process of the scapula. So this is the scapula here, and this is where it attaches. This process here is the coracoid process. It is innervated by the medial pectoral nerve, C8 and T1. The function of this muscle is to stabilize the scapula by drawing it inferiorly and anteriorly against the thoracic wall. Now I should talk about the subclavius. This muscle here is the subclavius. As you can see, it originates from the first rib right here before the cartilage of the first rib. So it originates here. The place where it inserts is on the clavicle, and actually it's here, one groove. The groove is called the subclavian groove of the clavicle. The nerve is the subclavius, the nerve that innervates it, and it serves for the depression of the clavicle. And finally, the last muscle I will talk about in this video is the serratus anterior. It is this muscle here. So it originates from the fleshy slips from the outer surface of the upper 8 or 9 ribs. The serratus anterior inserts on scapula here. Actually, the exact place of insertion is the medial border, but we have to look at it from the front point of view to see it. It is the medial border of the scapula and the anterior or the costal surface of the scapula here. The nerve that innervates this muscle is the long thoracic nerve from the roots of the brachial plexus C5, C6, and C7. The function of this nerve is to protect and stabilize the scapula and assist in upward rotation of the scapula. To understand why does it assist it in the upward rotation, well, just look at the origin and look at the insertion. What do you think? How is it gonna rotate?
These lessons come as part of my software called the Flash Human Anatomy. If you want to purchase my software, please go to my website flashhumananatomy.com. With my software, you get all my lessons, my very own illustrations, and my 3D models. Before you go to my website, please leave a positive comment or just a like. I put a link to my website in the description of this video.